Hi, I'm Kate Fanelli. I'm the coordinator at Alt Shift, and I'm a trainer for Foundations of Math and Foundations of Math teaching students with significant disabilities. Today we're talking about the learning trajectories. The learning trajectories come from researchers Doug Clements and Julie Sarama and help answer the question, my students need help in math, where do I start? Well, there's three simple steps to get started with the learning trajectories. The first step is to get to know them. So if you haven't done so already, I recommend downloading the learning trajectories and the learning trajectories handouts. The Learning Trajectories download is published by Numberworlds and includes most of the trajectories. To see a complete set, you'll need to go to Doug Clements and Julie Sarama's website, learningtrajectories.org. So take a minute to look through the document and get an idea of how the learning trajectories work. For more information, you can watch the short 2.5 minute video of Doug Clements describing how the trajectories work.
Learning trajectories are a three-part thing. They include a goal, a developmental sequence through which kids learn certain topics, and activities that are matched to each of those levels. So let's go through each of those. For instance, in a learning trajectory for addition and subtraction, your goal would be for kids to understand how to add and subtract, of course. The developmental sequence would take you through levels of thinking, early levels, for instance, in which kids could use blocks to be able to combine sets and then count them all to be able to understand how many there are in all. And then very much later levels where, of course, they can just say, oh, 5 plus 6 is 11 because 5 and 5 is 10. I know that, and one more is 11. So they learn more sophisticated counting strategies to the point where they can add double and triple digit numbers. So those are the levels. There's a progression of levels through which kids naturally follow. Research has identified specific paths or trajectories that kids follow when they're learning those topics. And that's the developmental progression piece of a learning trajectory. So the last piece, and this is what makes it particularly interesting, takes it beyond developmental psychology and into the realm of teaching and education, is that we now know that there are effective activities for every level of thinking to help kids move from this level to the next level in their development of these topics. So learning trajectories include a mathematical goal, a developmental progression of levels of thinking through which kids naturally progress, and activities that are specifically designed to enhance kids' movement from one level to the next.